Your thoughts, because you said there was a problem for you earlier that you weren't getting invitations to speak at universities because you lack credentials.
That's in the old days. Today,
yeah, but now it's changing, right?
It's changing. Yeah. Now I'm invited all over the world to speak at universities.
Large conferences we have coming up.
Yeah, all over the world. What's the next one?
Well, the next thing, well, England, you know about England. Then we get back for a week.
Tomorrow.
And then we go to Mexico for a few days where Jacques is getting it. They're giving him an international design award from this big design magazine. We say it's big because it costs $50 an issue. So they're giving him that, and he's the keynote speaker there. Mm-hmm. Jack's not interested in awards, but it might be helpful for something. So we're going.
Yeah.
So, and then from there we're going to El Salvador, where they're having a 2-day conference a 2-day seminar on the Venus Project. And our main reason for going to El Salvador was because there was just elected a left-wing progressive president, and Chavez came when he was inaugurated. And we really would like to address all the progressive Latin American presidents and introduce this direction. So we're seeing if we can get an audience with the president down there while we're there, or meet some people who can.
Socialism and communism is not radical enough. It doesn't. They don't know what to do when they get into power. They don't know what to build.
Maybe it's still in the way to progress.
Yeah, because we'd like to see if they would build the first city.
Yeah.
Yeah, because they're grappling as to which way to go. They're trying to change their constitution, and they're looking for new ways, but they're asking the old-time socialists, and they have no new direction updated with their
socialists
technology.
Socialists concerned with labor, that they own the means of production, but I want to free labor from going to work, so they can study whatever the hell you want to study. See,
then there's another conference coming up, like 6 months later, some big green conference in Abu Dhabi that they asked Jacques to be a keynote speaker. And it's in United Arab Emirates near Dubai.
Oh.
And it's funny because the same conference, Clinton is speaking.
And one of these can use his words.
So it's going to be interesting.
Obama never says anything that can change the world. And he wants to give medical care, you know, to people, but they have to buy into that insurance company, so none of that's any good. It won't work. So I don't worry about whether the future will come. It'll come, but we might kill each other. We might get involved in nuclear war. That's why I speak out. That's why I care about it. Because I'm afraid of the direction all societies are moving in. They're all full of shit. I'm not a proud American or a proud Swede or anything. I just know the world needs a new direction, different, that people can accept. It has to be presented in acceptable ways. Then they say to me, well, who makes the decisions? How do you decide against one project or another? We try many different projects, and the one that works best, we use. So we design many buildings in the future. Then we ask people to volunteer to live in them. So he lives in there and he says, the goddamn elevators move too fast and it closed up my grandmother, the doors. So we work on that until he likes the building, then we put them up. We don't put up any dams or power project until a group from our study, the technical staff, studies the positive effects of a dam and the negative. So nothing is built until the negative retroaction of any project is studied first. Like if people have access to their needs, will they want to work or do anything? Or will they just sit around and smoke pot? And what will they, how do you prevent that? That's the negative retroaction. If people have access to things, what will happen to incentive? We have to deal with all those things. And we've found ways of dealing with them. See, I work with different groups, changing them all the time.
Yeah.
People come to our place as tourists, and they come in one way and they walk out different.
Yeah.
In one session, which runs about 5 or 6 hours, you know, because I take questions and criticism and everything else. And then after that, they want to get photographed with me. I said, the government might pick me up, you know, because if it works too fast, the government's going to pick me up. I know that because a senator told me that in Washington. He said, if you begin to convince people too fast, we might pick you up because you're troublesome. you're in the way. I says, how do you do that? And the senator told me. He said, we put drugs in your car, and then we pick you up. And your friends will think, there was always something strange about Jock anyway. You know, that's the way normal people react.
Yeah.
So if I'm in jail, I will write. You know, come and see me.
Yeah.
But if you take photographs of me, you endanger your future.
Yeah.
You know, the FBI, the CIA, they pick you up. See? So understand that whenever you attack, and I attack every culture, not just this one, so the chances of making it are less. Unless you package it in such a way that you don't come there to hurt them.
Yeah.
If you can get that across, that you're not, you don't disagree with them, but like people believe in...